Hi, everybody. So this is Emily again. This is our very last blog post. And it sounds like this week we're going to be talking about nurses and influence and how we can get our voices heard. So one of the things that we watched was the PowerPoint presentation. And I was a little surprised by what I saw because, let's see what my notes were about this. It's because one of the slides said that the nurses were going to be the least likely profession to influence the healthcare, to influence the health reform. And that's what all these other people were thinking. And I was really shocked because one of the nurses' biggest jobs is being an advocate and speaking up when issues need to be heard. So to think that we would be the least likely to make any sort of difference, it was sort of a low blow, but we can change that. And I don't think that the general public really understands what nurses do. I mean, they understand we give meds, we heal, but there's still this like sexy nurse image of a woman like in a scanty clad, whatever. And they don't really understand that we're not just there to wipe your butt, give you meds, do what we, there's so much that we do that I can't even verbalize. Mm-hmm. So let alone how could the public pick up on that? So in any case, but I was also very gratified, that in the survey or in the PowerPoint that I saw that people wanted nurses to have more influence over planning and policy development and management. And so, you know, that's a huge vote of confidence. So even though they don't think that we can do it, they want us to do it. So that's a clear message that we really need to get on the ball and start advocating and start having our voices being heard. And so one of the ways to do that would be to, there are so many different things that you can do. I mean, one of the things is joining the American Nurses Association. Here, let me pull up their website because their mission statement is pretty clear. I mean, they do a whole bunch of things, but another thing that they say is, they project a positive and realistic view of nursing, and they lobby Congress and regulatory agencies on healthcare issues affecting nurse and the public. So it's like the ANA is taking a very active stance to make sure their voice is heard, not just on a small level, but on a national, perhaps even maybe globally affecting level. So that's a really good place to start. I found this really interesting article. It's called Policy and Politics, Why Nurses Should Get Involved. It's by Osberg. And it was really interesting because that was an article about other ways that nurses could get involved and get their voices heard. And one of the ways is to sort of start off on a more local level, you know, become really involved in your facility or your organization and make sure that your voice is heard there. And I have done that to a certain extent, getting policies written and getting things changed to make sure that patient care is better, particularly for ostomy patients, because that's what I like. So you can start off local and you can work up from there. They also made the suggestion that you could internship with your local or your state legislators. That way you would have you'd have more of an input on healthcare policies and things like that. So it was an interesting article. So one of the things that in our blog we're supposed to touch on is that many nurses feel that as just one person they cannot make sweeping changes to the healthcare system. And you know, what can we do to take a stronger leadership role in improving healthcare services is to really step beyond the role of the transactional leadership role where you're just in there, you do your job and you get out, and you're not really thinking. you really need to take on a transitional leadership role where you are going to get out there, you're going to inspire people. A lot of times it's by your charisma and your energy alone. And sometimes you do have to start off small and work big. And I think one person can make a huge difference. There was Florence Nightingale. She made a huge difference. There was Clara Barton. There were a couple of other nurses. And, I mean, I know that those are a little bit further in the past, but there's always the potential that one nurse could make a difference. And as far as within my hospital, there was Nurse Sally Maragni. She was there forever and ever and ever, and now she's semi-retired. But basically every form that we see in the hospital was something that she developed. And a lot of the policies and a lot of procedures are in place because of things that she has done that are evidence-based practiced or that she has researched. She's a phenomenal woman. She actually was one of my preceptors when I was a new nurse, you know, 5+ years ago. And she was what has inspired me to want to become a leader and take a more active stance. So definitely one nurse can make a huge difference on a local, maybe even a regional level. But if you're making an influence that far, other people are going to notice. So I think there's potential there that one nurse could potentially change healthcare.